evening. Welcome to St. Luke's annual Blue Christmas service. I'm really glad that you took time out of your busy schedules and at the end of your day to come for a peaceful service for hope and healing. A service that is meant to be quiet, to help us find our center in the midst of the chaos and the storms that seem to swirl about us each day. So I invite those of you viewing from home to light a candle to sanctify your space, or have your Advent candle prepared to light as we walk through the lighting ceremony later in our service. We cry out to Christ who counts and collects our tears. Be with us now, O Christ. In our grief and our pain, our bodies and spirits cry out. Hear us, O Christ. Amen. Let us pray. The days are short, the nights are long, Almighty God. Your universe mirrors the reality of our hearts, revealing your gracious spirit that mourns with us in grief, cries with us in sorrow, sits with us in despair. You are not a distant God removed from human pain, but a faithful companion closer to us than our own breath. Help us to feel your presence now as we remember and reflect, seeking your healing touch and the hope that was promised and delivered in Jesus Christ, your Son, our Savior. Amen. Well, I'm taking a point of privilege here to move my words of hope earlier in the service. It's a little bit of a daunting task to think that you are meant to deliver words of hope, not really knowing what those words of hope might be to each one of you. So I'm going to offer a few reflections and suggestions and invite you to find hope where you can this evening through the reading of our scriptures, perhaps in the songs that are sung. But a couple of things stand out to me. And I hear people say frequently, God doesn't give us more than we can handle. And while I believe that's true to some extent, I don't believe God gives us everything that happens to us. I believe that our world and life can sometimes give us things that are too much to bear. But Emmanuel, God with us, God promises to be with us no matter what life deals us. And I love the quote on the front of your leaflet where it says, all darkness in the world cannot extinguish the light of a single candle. So on a day where you're feeling especially hopeless or down or discouraged, light a candle. Light a candle to remind yourself of Emmanuel, that even in those difficult, trying, dismal days, God is with you. There is so much in our world today that could bring us grief and loss apart from our own personal grief and loss. We might be grieving for those in Kentucky and five other states that are reeling from the disastrous tornado. Maybe tonight you will pray for those who have lost loved ones, who have lost homes, who have lost their entire communities. Perhaps that's a communal grief that we can all bear and share together. Maybe you're struggling with illness or someone you love dearly is struggling with illness. Come tonight and pray for them. Lift them up for God's healing touch. Maybe you're struggling with the political ugliness that just continues to get more and more polarized. Let us all pray together that somehow we find the middle ground. And as Episcopalians, we're familiar with that via media, the middle way. Let us pray for our political divides that somehow there will be a turn and we will find the middle way. And there are certainly many things on the horizon with racial divisions, and right here in our community, there are things that need to be done to bring racial reconciliation and healing. Let us continue to pray for that in our own neighborhoods, in our own city, and definitely in our nation. Maybe you're living with fears of aging, weakness, illness that comes with the joys of being on this planet longer. Maybe you need God's comfort and presence with you as you face the unknowns that lie ahead. And then there's this thing called languishing. It seems to be part of living in a pandemic that seems to never have an end in sight. There's this thing of languishing where we've lost our everyday way and we're quite not sure how to go ahead and what's the new normal going to be. Languishing is normal. So if you're feeling a lack of energy or motivation, know that you are not alone. And speaking of being alone, loneliness is also a pandemic. And it's not just a result of COVID. Loneliness was already a pandemic around the world. And COVID has only complicated that. So if you're feeling lonely, reach out to someone. Sometimes people don't have a clue how lonely we are. So ask someone to sit with you. Maybe they can't fix it, but maybe they can just be with you in your loneliness. So you will remember Emmanuel, God with you. I'm going to invite you, if you would like this evening, in any of the spaces between the Psalms and between the singing, if you would like to come forward for anointing, I would be honored to anoint you. I have some wonderful anointing oil that's frankincense and myrrh. And I will, it's a biblical thing, it's a godly thing. And anointing is about being blessed, being empowered and protected. And don't we all need that today? So if you'd like to step aside, I'm going to sit over here. Step over, I would be honored to pray for you and bless you and anoint you. You can tell me what the prayer is for, or you can just step ahead. God knows, I don't have to know. And I'm also going to anoint you on your wrist so that you take the wonderful aroma of the Holy Spirit with you from this place. And remember, even as you get home, Emmanuel, God is with you. And now we begin lighting our Advent candles. We light the first candle to remember those whom we have lost through death. We remember their names aloud or in the silence of our hearts. We treasure the memories that bind them to us. Let us remember that God's eternal love surrounds them. We light the second candle to ask for deliverance from the pain of loss, the loss of relationships, of jobs, of health, of financial security. We ask God to place the gift of peace in our waiting hearts. Refresh, restore, renew us, O God, and lead us into your future.
Christ, now comes in May.
We light the third candle for each of us. We offer to God our past, the times of regret and sorrow, the times of mourning, the difficult memories, the times of grief and sadness and loneliness and pain. Let us remember that God's dawn defeats despair. We light the fourth candle as a symbol of hope and promise. We invite the coming of the one who brings us into new being. Let us remember the one who shows the way and who is with us tonight and into tomorrow.
God, will you forget me forever? How long will you hide your face from me? How long must I bear pain in my soul and have sorrow in my heart all day long? How long shall my enemy be exalted over me? Consider and answer me, my God and Savior. Give light to my eyes, or I will sleep the sleep of death. And my enemy will say, I have prevailed. My foes will rejoice because I am shaken. But I trusted in your steadfast love. My heart shall rejoice in your salvation. I will sing to the Almighty because God has dealt bountifully with me.
Hear my cry, O God. Listen to my prayer. From the end of the earth I call to you when my heart is faint. Lead me to the rock that is higher than I, for you are my refuge, a strong tower against the enemy. Let me abide in your tent forever. Find refuge under the shelter of your wings. For God alone my soul waits in silence. From God comes my salvation. God alone is my rock and my salvation, my fortress. I shall never be shaken.
Oh, God. Where can I go from your spirit? Or where can I flee from your presence? If I ascend into heaven, you are there. If I make my bed in Sheol, you are there. If I take the wings of the morning and settle at the farthest limits of the sea, even there your hand shall lead me. Your right hand shall hold me fast. And I say, surely the darkness shall cover me, and the light around me become night. Even the darkness is not dark to you. The night is as bright as the day, for darkness is as light to you.
I lift up my eyes to the hills. From where will my help come? My help comes from God, who made heaven and earth. God will not let your foot be moved. God who keeps you will not slumber. God who keeps Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Holy One is your keeper. The Holy One is your shade at your right hand. The sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. God will keep you from all evil. God will keep your life. God will keep your going out and your coming in from this time on and forevermore.
God is my shepherd. I don't need a thing. You have bedded me down in lush meadows. You find me quiet pools from which to drink. True to your word, you let me catch my breath and send me in the right direction. Even when the way goes through Death Valley, I'm not afraid when you walk at my side. Your trusty shepherd's crook makes me feel secure. You serve me a six-course dinner right in front of my enemies. You revive my drooping head. My cup brims with blessing. Your beauty and love chase after me every day of my life. I am back home in the house of God for the rest of my life.
In the spirit of this season, let us ask God for what we need for ourselves. As people coping with loss, pain, suffering, loneliness, grief, and sadness, we seek the comfort of God's presence. Gracious God, we come to you as Christmas approaches, as the nights have been growing longer, the darkness around us has deepened. In this season of our longest nights, we offer to you all that we hold in our hearts. Loving God, hear our prayer and answer with your love. Compassionate God, we grieve for what might have been. The joy of Christmas is blanketed by the loss that has changed everything. We find ourselves adrift, alone and lost. We need your help to find our way. Loving God, hear our prayer and answer with your love. Caring God, the Christmas season reminds us of all that once was and is no longer. The sounds of celebration around us add to the ache in our hearts. Please be near us this night. Loving God, hear our prayer and answer with your love. God of all, we are not alone in our loss and our sadness. Be with all those whose lives are touched by sadness during this Christmas season, especially the people that were most impacted by the tornadoes, so many that have lost homes, lives, family members, and their communities. Gracious God, we ask your intervention and that you would use each and every one of us as a restoring presence in your world. Let your peace fill the world tonight. Loving God, hear our prayer
and answer with your love.
I invite you to stand as you are able. As Christ taught us, together we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. May the God of infinite grace scatter the weight of despair and strengthen your hearts with holiness. And may God's blessing be with you. May Christ's peace be with you. And may the Spirit's outpouring be with you now, this evening, through the rest of Advent and the Christmas season, and into the new year. Amen.